So the first deck that we're playing today is this UK-US pin ramp deck. This is a modified list of what I used to get the UK to Field Marshal last season. Just thought I'd try switching things up a little bit, try something new. So I call it pin ramp because we have a little bit of a pinning sub theme in here. Obviously, if you've been playing the game for a while, you know that some of the better UK cards that allow them to stall the game, get to the late game, are cards like this Blackburn Skua and the Albacore Mark I that pin enemy units. And so we're just upping the amount of cards that have that sort of effect. And hopefully, while we're doing that, we're powering up our Cromwell Mark IVs here, which say that every time we destroy a pinned unit, they get plus two attack. I think this card's fairly solid stat line for the cost as is, but if you can even get this thing to trigger once, it starts becoming a really solid threat. So I thought we'd give it a try. Just like I said, try something new, switch things up a bit. Other small changes I made based on the list last season, because we saw some nerfs to the more aggressive decks, or like the aggressive starts from the from certain mid-range and aggressive decks from last season. I've changed a few cards around. For example, we're running now, instead of War Machine, I decided 332nd Engineer Regiment might be the better ramp card in this deck, just because it is a 2/2 that can trade into a lot of the early units that that more aggressive decks might be playing. We went up a War Bonds. We went up a Lend-Lease instead of a Convoy. So if you look at the curve, we're definitely got a lot of top end, but we also, you know, our mid game is all about ramping up to that top end. So anyway, I said last season that instead of waiting and putting UK to the end, I wanted to try to get it to Field Marshal as early as possible, just to get it out of the way. So we're gonna start with this, see how it goes. I normally like to play each deck for about an hour on stream, but depending on how much fun we're having, how successful we are, we might cut this one short and just move on to some of the other decks I'm more looking forward to playing today than showing off some of the changes that have recently come about with this new patch. But we're gonna, like I said, we'll start here, see how we do. Oh, and for those not aware who may have seen the D-Day challenge, so what the D-Day challenge is in a nutshell is that the community has been tasked with completing several objectives. D-Day themed objectives. For those who don't know, it's the 76th anniversary of D-Day. And I think I want against a potentially aggressive deck. Those two at least. He could also be control, and then this is not the greatest. And then I want more ramp cards. Let's toss these back, keep these. I think that's solid. Yeah, that's a pretty solid hand. Anyway, the devs have tasked the community with completing certain objectives every day, and if we do so, we get rewards. And one of the decks we'll be playing today does actually work towards one of today's objective. So we're gonna work on that a little bit today, although it is 99% completed, so it might not be necessary. Yeah, so no plays for the first two turns indicates to me that this is a control list. So definitely going to look to just our next two turns are almost certainly just going to be 332nd into War Bonds. Okay. Playing Japan Britain naval support. That's interesting. I've not seen that before. That could be fun. Okay, he's just playing like stall, like he's just looking to stall us out or deny us resources. I'm fine with that. Definitely playing this out, and then we can play this next turn. Probably just gonna slow him down. If he wants to throw, like, if he wants to spend a resource and have these take damage, I'm fine with that. Even after buffing it with naval support. Although the Black Watch was annoying, we didn't actually have that many orders in hand, so it wasn't the worst. Sure. Do I just ramp here? I think that's what I want to do. He could naval support this, and then he has kind of a nasty bomber, but I don't think it's that big of a deal, really. Could just pin it. We'll pin it afterwards, maybe. I think we'll just do this now because he's likely to have, like, he could be running the new blockade, which increases the cost of cards you have in hand. He could be playing another Black Watch, so let's just get that out of the way. If he commits the naval support to this unit, so be it. We'll find ways to take it out. I could see him, like, killing this with these two attacks, moving this forward and hitting this with naval support because it has fury. But if he does that, we have a lot of ways to take out ground units. Yeah, and now we just... So... Let's actually pin everything to start. This... We could finish that off with this Kitty Hawk next turn, potentially. This thing having one more health isn't really relevant, even though this wasn't a big threat, I'd rather just remove it. Yeah, hey Wurtz, we're doing a little bit of a longer stream today. I think I might be going for another hour. So we're looking to do 5 decks today instead of our usual 4. So that's kind of scary. I think I'm obligated to take this out before he starts doing some shenanigans with it. So I could go like Blackburn and throw this into here. He's playing British cards, so he probably has a lot of sweepers, which is unfortunate because we don't... We don't want to go too wide. And I think I kind of need to pin something. Let's just do this. Because I don't want him to like bomb, finish this off with this bomber and then eat this bomber with this fighter. I'm glad that... How's the game audio? It seems a little low. Okay, there's just nothing happening right now, that's why. Apologies in advance for... Hey Cole, is it Cole or Cole? Cole? How are you doing today? I was going to say, I apologize in advance if you guys can hear a lot of background noise. You might be hearing some traffic in the background because I have the window open because it is quite hot today where I am. OK, Okay, so that's gonna continue to be pinned. Okay, last one. So it was call. So sorry, which one was it? Kala? Kali? Kala or Kali? It's probably not Kali. Kala? Okay. Start with this. Pin that. Finish it off. Hope that he doesn't have like send what is that card? Hopefully he doesn't have the oh man, I'm blanking on the name. The bomber that increases order damage by one and then like double Tora Tora Tora, I think would kill our board. Outside of that exact scenario, we're in an okay spot. Okay. So let's just throw this away. I think I'm actually fine throwing that away and eating this. We'll just play this out. Oh yes, worth noting, he has two naval supports in hand right now. Very nice. Think we just play out one of these to start. Do I want to play the Pioneering Company? Probably not. Doesn't really do anything. Doesn't really do anything if I keep it in hand. Yep. Yeah, you at the start of the video, you'll see it on YouTube later, or if you watch this replay on Twitch. We are running the Cromwell in this deck. Yeah, we're definitely running the Cromwell in this deck. Because we have, as I explained before, I think it's just a solid unit in general, and then we actually have like a number of pin effects. I've also upped the number of pin effects in this deck compared to the list that I was playing at the end of last season, just because I wanted to try something new. I think the Cromwell, like even if its text box triggers only once, it's like a pretty solid four drop, and if it triggers twice, it's twice or more, it starts to get insane. I hate this card, by the way. We were like in a reasonable spot, and then he played this. Yeah. It's just so swingy. I don't think I'll ever like the design of this card. Ho hum. And like the problem is, it's like, how do I, he still has like the potential for To the Last Man in his deck too. Like Japan already has so many like comeback mechanics like this. Do they need like this really obnoxious one too? Since this thing can't block either of these two, and but then again, we did see a blitzy fighter from him before, so. Yep. Doesn't do much. So like what I would want to do at is take this out with this and then bomb this, but this could just there's a 25% chance that it just takes this card away from us. But I think that's pretty much our only option at this point. Yeah. I think, I don't know that our deck wants that card, but yes, that is a very good card against this now. If you're running US and you're like a little bit more like a US aggressive deck, that's probably a card worth considering. And it hit the exact card that we needed, so. That's fine. Game wasn't very fun anyway. It was interesting until our opponent refilled their hand and took away a unit. Maybe I'm supposed to throw back basically everything but the 5th Brigade, looking for a another Japanese. Oh man, is that all we're gonna face today is like Japanese control decks? Next turn, I guess we can Blackburn pin this and then threaten to bomb this, and it only gets one measly card instead of two. Good chance he just has like air superiority though. Yeah, I played a game. What did I play? I played a game earlier. I played some games earlier this week, and some guy used Overwhelming Force on my guard units in my Soviet midrange deck, and it was pretty effective. I don't think he ended up winning the game, but it was close. I can't remember the result of the game, but it was close either way. Either I barely won, or he barely won, or I barely lost. Right, he probably has Ultra, like that's probably what he's holding up here, so I'm not gonna run that out. He doesn't have Ultra up anymore, so we'll just bomb him now. Could be we just die to a like bunch of blitzy planes this game. This deck notably is not running any like fortification or anything, so. Yep, that's fine. Need more B-17s. I mean, this deck is definitely not one that's on my radar anymore. I guess I'm not surprised people still play it. It's been fringe playable for a while now. We have a US German deck that does much better against decks like this because if we have things like Sudden Strike and Flammenpanzer to take out their like early game, and then stuff like wow, he just has everything, eh? I guess he's seen a billion cards, so it's not like super surprising. And then when they go big like this, we also have the Avengers and B-17s and Death from Above's to take care of them. We are playing that deck later today, actually. So I mean, we'll take another couple draw steps, I guess, depending on what he plays. But he's seen so many cards, and he's gotten so much value off of even like his early game stuff that this game's almost certainly over. And he's taking forever. So rather than like wait, like we're on the rank floor. So there's like we don't need to works super hard for the 1% chance we're winning that game, I don't think. Some guy weed whacking outside the window. I don't know if you guys can hear that. It's very annoying. I might just mute the mic when there's nothing to say in that case. Yeah, I mean, like, why keep playing a game you're not having fun with? This is a game. It's supposed to be fun. If you're not having fun, move on. I think I'll save both of these for now. Sure. That hurt. What did he lose? Leo? Well, I don't know why you have a 10 drop in your aggro deck anyway, so. Nice. I don't really want to take 6 damage, so I think I'm playing Monty here. Really would like to start playing other things though. really annoying. I think I just have to... It's kind of like damned if you do, damned if you don't. I either let him draw a bunch of cards and I eventually lose to that, or I lose because his units just keep killing me. This also is going to kill one of my guys. We're like two turns off from the sweeper. Yeah, I think we just need to live. So I think I'm just going to have to let him have the cards. Next turn we can like kill this, pin one of these two. That ramped us and gained us two health as far as I'm concerned, so that's really good. None of those cards are very good, so I guess I'll take away this. He's drawing a ton of cards, that's the sad thing. So we're probably gonna need like another carpet bombing very, very soon. How do we want to do this? I can't hit this with anything, so my thought is I want to pin this and then bomb this. Or sorry, pin this so it can't take the front line and he can encirclement. And then I would want a death from above this, but there's no guarantee that hits it, so. Guess we just go for this. I mean, he can chat all he wants. We haven't seen a single Cromwell in any of our games, have we? That's pretty good. That is pretty good. No, we don't want to do that. Oh, that was a mistake, eh? I should have put this on the other side, because he probably has a... He could have a blitzy tank to kill this. I'd much rather him not be able to eat that. That was a mistake. But I also want to protect this just in case he has, like, a bunch of blitz stuff into Blitzkrieg. He's probably gonna get the tank now. I'd be surprised if we live if this lives. Okay. Continuing to be surprised, but for a different reason. I don't want to clog up my support line, so I don't think I'll play this. It doesn't do much. Yeah, unless you're an aggressive deck and you're racing. If you can kill something, you should kill something. Throw this out, see what it hits. And then I think we just chill. Of course, in the end, all this effort that we're putting in won't matter because he'll just play he'll just play a whatchamacallit eventually. Empire of the Sun. Shelling. Yes, we probably want to play that before we kill this, because I don't really I care about either of these. Obviously, I care a little bit more about the other thing, but. Yep. Yay, we got to play it. We won with a Cromwell. Woo! Technically, Cromwell won that game. Mission accomplished. Cromwell officially, as of right now, has a 100% win rate. And every game that we've seen him, we've won the game. Cromwell, new meta. Cromwell, new meta confirmed. That being said, we probably toss him back for this opening hand. Oh, okay. Come on, Cromwell, don't fail us now. We're on a one-game win streak. That card's kind of annoying, but... Ooh. Hopefully he just plays out a bunch more stuff here. Play something else. So it is noteworthy that because our deck doesn't have, like, healing in it, definitely at risk of, just, like, dying because of the health. Like, our opponent can reasonably race us here, is what I'm trying to say. Oh, Cat Yusha, Cat Yusha. 5, 7, 8, 9. Alright, let's pin some stuff. Hopefully next turn we get our Cromwell on. I'm sure this is about to eat a hammer, but... Oh my god. I was just about to say, another Chaika would be awful for us. Because it blocks us from killing the, whatchamacallit. Yeah, that would be pretty good. Sure. What do we want to do? Kind of want to just do clear the board. Hold up Ultra. Really? He had two of those in hand and he decided to just trade the Avenger for the Cromwell. Like, his life total is super high. I don't understand why you would do that. Well, here's hoping he doesn't have another B7, another Avenger. You know what would have been really nice? One of our two land leases. That's a card. Gonna keep this. There's no point in keeping it back. Poor Comet. Mission accomplished if we can get that to hit hit someone's HQ even once. I think the card is good, but the problem is there's just too many hammers and Avengers running around, I think. Opponent has all the cards. Hopefully that didn't hit anything good. Sure. Guess I'll move that forward. We can actually get to a place where, if he's just drawing infinite these things, we actually just win. Okay, let's start by how much resources we have. 9, attacking with this would be 12. 13, 14, 15, but then I wouldn't get to attack with this. Not the biggest of deals. Don't think we can. Like, I want to try to minimize the chances of this hitting something good by playing out a fifth brigade as well, but then we don't quite have enough resources to do everything I want to do. Chances are we need to throw this into this anyway, which is even worse. Start with this and see what it hits. Literally the worst thing? Sure. Why not? All right. sucks. Alright, come on top deck. Lendlease. A B17 that hits this. Something. Oh my god, I hate this card and its RNG so much. Well, I technically got what I asked for. So you're saying there's a chance. No, it's definitely a nerf overall. It's just I just find the RNG incredibly frustrating to play against, personally. To play with and against. Hopefully he just draws these for the next few turns, because they don't really do anything. Hopefully this lives, and he just keeps drawing these forever. Yes. Okay, pin his stuff. Oops, no, that was a misclick. I meant to hit this thing. Fuck. It's okay. He's gonna just draw one of those guard units, and we're gonna draw another pin thing. It's gonna be okay. Yeah. See, what did I say? Dude, you're supposed to keep drawing guard units and that's it. What's the matter with you? Well, that's awkward. Definitely just gonna die to that thing, aren't we? Oh, that's perfect. Is it? Not if he has another guard unit, I guess. Well, darn. How many of these things does he have? Oh, this is must be what his parade hit. Yeah, that's what it is. Alright, so we're just dead to this. Or are we? I mean, probably, but... There's not enough time for us to kill him, so this game's over, but whatever. We're gonna keep playing with our Cromwell if we can. Where was this like 7,000 turns ago? I guess we had already played the one in the early game, right? That's still this game. All right, we've been playing this deck for about an hour and it's like not performing well. So this is the last game. We're gonna move on to new deck. Just British things. I don't know. If anyone out there has a good British list, feel free to DM it to me. Because it never feels good playing this nation to me.